Well, there it is. That's a little Indian ringneck. Oops, it's gone, but it'll be straight back. What did I want to say about it? Well, they're feral in Western Australia, and they're displacing all the native parrots. They're taking all the native parrots' homes and things. And that isn't good, really. What's up on the telephone wires now? It'll be down in a minute. But they're taking over in Western Australia. There are flocks of green, well, Indian ringneck parrots. I don't know if they're all green, but that one's green. They come in, the caged varieties come in green and yellow and blue. But the fact is they're feral over there. And the law in Western Australia, so I could make out, says that you've got to have double doors on your bird cages. Just landed, but it just flew away again, probably intimidated by the cockatoos. You're supposed to have double doors on your bird cages in Western Australia, so they're very more strict over there. I don't know what the law is in New South Wales, but I know by the sound of that parrot that other neighbours of mine have got the same type of parrot in cages, because I can hear that parrot talking to them. It'll be down in a minute. But they're obviously going to become feral here in New South Wales, aren't they? They are. Where are you? There you are. Little feral, aren't you beautiful? Little feral bird. You're going to take over in New South Wales, aren't you, and drive out all the local parrots. One of my commenters, a YouTube commenter friend of mine, suggested that, well, birds kept in cages are caged ornaments. It would make a beautiful ornament though, wouldn't it? I could teach it to speak. There are lots of videos on teaching on these little parrots talking. Of course, cockatoos talk too, but you're not allowed to just go and catch wild cockatoos. So, that's the problem. Should these birds be shot? Should they be captured? Should they be put to sleep? What is the solution? You can tell me what you think. Because they're feral, and they're going to become feral in New South Wales, obviously. And they're going to be everywhere. They're even feral in Britain, actually. They fly around parts of Britain where they've been introduced. But aren't they beautiful? Lovely. As lovely as any Australian parrot. Isn't it lovely? I do feel sorry for it. I sort of wish it had a friend of its own. But if it did have a friend, if it was heterosexual and had a friend, he or she would be having babies all over the place, wouldn't they? They would. Who is that nearby? Looks like some little zebra, not zebra finches, double-barred finches. Where are they? Let's have a look at the double-barred finches. There they are. Owl finches. They do have faces like owls, don't they? Recessed. They're little cuties too, but they're native to Australia. Sometimes we have red-browed firetails, but I haven't been able to film any yet. In the summertime there are red-browed firetails here. But back to this little feral thing. Where are you? There you are. Aren't you so beautiful? He doesn't seem to have any friends. He sort of has a love-hate relationship with a local galah, those pink cockatoos called galahs. He has a sort of, he gets chased all the time by a sort of pink galah, and that's sort of his relationships, really. And he can screech at the birds in cages in the local village. I suppose they're going to take over. I wouldn't be sorry to see big flocks of green parrots, but I would be sorry if they displaced the local parrots. Isn't it beautiful? Isn't it lovely? Gorgeous. See you again.